Look at this.
Oh, what is this?
So, again, I didn't know, right? So we found, so as I was just kind of warming it up and as we were kind of vamping to, you know, to kind of introduce the game to you, I was climbing up that mountain and I'm like, what is this? And so there's a little glyph over here, which I have no idea what it's for, but it leads to this, it unlocks this cloud thing. I don't know what this is. Again, we played Vivian Clark last time. This is a game where we're just discovering stuff as we go. There is so much hidden in this game.
What is this?
What the heck is this game?
Hello, Internet. Welcome to Game.
Hey, guys, and welcome to GT Live. How are you?
Happy Tuesday.
Happy Tuesday!
Tuesday, right?
It's Tuesday. It's Tuesday. It's Tuesday.
You're watching us on YouTube.com.
GT Live. It's Tuesday.
This is so fun.
I love the internet. So, hey,
we've been watching too much Poppy.
What? No. So anyway, hey, welcome to GT Live, Tuesday edition. Today we are continuing a game that we discovered before the week break. It is a video game that has gotten panned by critics across the internet and is probably one of the best games that I have played in months, I would say.
Wow.
Oh, Jason is saying, Stephanie, you should mic up. You should put on a microphone.
I was feeling so naked. I was wondering why.
Whoa! Today we're playing a game that, or we're continuing to play a game that surprised all of us, I would say. It was labeled to us initially as 2016's most controversial game. It is a terrible.
That's the way it was marketed. 3D... That's the way one person wrote it in an email to us.
It was marketed that way, but what we discovered was a plethora of mystery and hidden lore and things like that. So today we continue our quest to figure out what secrets exist.
To drink all the soda.
All of it.
All of it.
And also find the secrets of the lore that I was building to and, you know. Then.
But it was really, but the soda. Became...
Drinkability! Soda Drinker Pro, let's do it.
All right.
All right, so here we go, Soda Drinker Pro. So for those of you who missed the first stream of this, first off, it's on the GT Live channel. Make sure you subscribe because we are close to 10,000 subscribers away from a million, which is incredible. That would be wonderful to hear that.
I know, wouldn't that be so lovely? So
here we go. Right. So this is the quality opening screen of Soda Drinker Pro. As you can tell, lots of time and effort went into it. It's truly, truly a work of art. So we're going to start here. Suck on this AAA gaming industry.
Yeah.
Hopping into level 2, which is where we stopped last time.
If this game even has levels.
Level 2.
It's really a bit unclear.
Steph, the park, walking with a nice cold soda.
It's true. Walking with it.
So as
it's weird that you have to start back here.
It is weird.
Are you sure that this is picking up where we left off?
This is picking up where we left off,
okay.
Yes. I double checked before the stream.
Okay, so while you're strolling through the park with a nice cold soda, I'm gonna say hello in the chat. Gloria Gutierrez says, yeah, soda. Dakota Daniel says, this is my first live stream. Clap and a half.
Man.
Woo!
Then you have picked truly the ultimate live stream to join.
The pinnacle of the GT Live experience right here. Kai Demon God says, what? Which is also an appropriate response to this stream. Other Helen says, hi. Shirty Derby says, okay. As in, okay, I'm ready to go. Like,
great.
I think they were really ready. They were like, okay, let's play. I'm so excited, says Witch 9. Why is this so cute, says Dolphineer 4. I don't know.
So this is interesting. So last time, last time we found the little secret place, which we're going to be hopping into, which appears to me to be the main game. So just to recap, right? So this game was sent to us, 2016's most controversial game or whatever. It had a lot of weird marketing behind it. We checked it out. And everyone online was like, oh, there's a bunch of hidden stuff in this game.
Yeah.
And I don't think anyone has ever had the dedication to actually play through it and find all the hidden stuff, because it's actually a legitimately, like, challenging game to play. But what we're seeing here is... Sorry, whoops. Flipping all over the place.
Jeez.
Whoa! Wait, hold up. This is completely different.
Wait, what?
So we found this glitch. So last time what we did, and again, this is on GT Live, last time what we did when we played this game, we went into this barn.
Right.
And that unlocked the minigame Vivian Clark.
Vivian Clark.
Which is this whole other metagame underneath Soda Drinker Pro. Which Soda Drinker Pro just looks like a badly, it's like Bubsy 3D. So we went through that door and we unlocked Soda Drinker Pro. Now though, look
oh,
at this.
What is this?
So again, I didn't know,
this?
Right? So we found, so as I was just kind of warming it up and as we were kind of vamping to, you know, to kind of introduce the game to you, I was climbing up that mountain and I'm like, what is this? And so there's a little glyph over here, which I have no idea what it's for, but it leads to this, it unlocks this cloud thing. I don't know what this is. Again. We played Vivian Clark last time. This is a game where we're just discovering stuff as we go. There is so much hidden in this game.
What is this?
What the heck is this game?
Oh, whoa.
What is this? So again, this is the reason why we want to play this game on the live stream. Because it is so
weird.
There is so much in it. That is such a weird mystery. I feel like I'm playing like a video game version of like Westworld or something.
Here, run past it so you don't get hit by it.
I am running. So note, Vivian Clark
is different.
Is different.
Not
this is
this.
This is a completely different thing.
Ah, shoot.
I thought maybe that's...
Oh, look, there's a soda.
Look, and the world is like fading away behind. Yeah, like the world is like disappearing away from us. But there's a whole, like, platforming stuff here. What is this? So anyway, what we're doing on the live stream with
so
you guys...
I'm so confused about this game.
...is trying to figure out what the heck is going on.
Yeah, and is there, like, is there a bigger story? What is it?
Cause
like, what's the point, sort of? What, why this game?
Why? Just why? What is going on? So, because this is a game where, you know, literally everything is hidden.
Exactly.
It is one thing, and we thought we had solved it, honestly. We thought, oh, we found Vivian Clark. That's all. And that's what I fully intended to play today, actually. As we were vamping.
Like, oh, hey, this weird thing.
I fully intended to be like, okay, let's hop into Vivian Pro and, like, continue. Because there's a bunch, it's basically WarioWare. There's a bunch of minigames that as you beat them, you unlock different things. And I figured once you unlock them all, you'll get something. Now, all of a sudden, we're just on a completely different adventure that I didn't even plan.
Now we can't even go back. Here, okay,
yeah, we
keep
just
going.
Continue
keep
forward.
Going, I guess. Walking through the park with the soda. All right. Are we falling now?
I believe we are falling into the abyss.
Can you look down or anything?
There is nothing. There is only blue. There is only soda.
Aw, man.
We may have died.
Ah.
Or something. I don't even
Shoot,
know.
Did we do it wrong? Wrong.
Right. You say wrong.
Is there a right?
But again, that's what's exciting about this game is there's so much.
Oh, did we get an achievement?
360 no scope and sip. We got an achievement of 360 no scope and sip. So that's what's so exciting about this game, and that's why I wanna, you know, share it with you guys. Drinking soda in a weird room. So
we've reached level 3.
So I figured.
Yeah, if you finish the soda, that it would.
That we would have to
end up somewhere else.
So here's our weird room.
Oh my gosh. What?
What was that glyph though? So that's nothing. That's just a floating thing.
That's so weird. Yes, soda.
Do you see any more glyphs around?
No, not yet, but we just started.
There's not
such a complex room.
I was
gonna
say
there's so
not a whole
uncover.
Lot to see, honestly, Stephanie. Maybe in this bag, like
maybe
there's
the
a little
corner?
Like back
yeah,
corner
little,
here.
Like, nope, that's just poorly constructed edge of the world. Okay.
Is it, or is there like, am I gonna fall out of the world again?
Oh.
I have indeed fallen out of the world again. Infinity more sodas to go. All right. Well.
What?
We're now drifting into the abyss. So that glyph, though, was so strange. So anyway, this is one of those, like, as the theorists that we are, it's like, there's something
there's
to solve
something
here. Between
yeah.
Vivian Clark, which I think I'm going to end up jumping into. I'm going to reload the game and...
What? Oh, we died.
Yeah, we're just... I mean, I could have progressed to level 4, but I want to hop into Vivian, because this is so much to deal with all at the same time. So, let's hop into Vivian Clark.
All right.
Which gets unlocked if you find it in the game.
Yeah.
So we unlocked this last time during the live stream. We played about an hour of it.
Yeah, just over an hour.
So this is the hidden game within it. And this is all I thought. You know, I thought that this was the only hidden thing, but apparently there's this whole glyph thing now. So who knows what this game has going for it.
Yeah, and so every single one of every part of Vivian Clark is a minigame. They all involve picking up these little, like, crystals or, like, bubbles or whatever they are. Those are always good. There's always things to avoid. And basically, you're a
yes.
water droplet, essentially.
Explain it to me, Steph, because...
So when it comes down to it, you're a water droplet, and your, like, central home base world is, like, a campfire. And you have to keep the fire burning so that you can throw your... I'm not making any of this up. So you can throw yourself into it and be vaporized into all of these little mini-games. See, there you are. You're a little droplet of water. I know it's tempting to say that you're a sperm, but you're not. You're a little droplet of water,
Stephanie,
that hurls yourself,
Stephanie, mature stream,
into the flames and then vaporizes and then ends up in lots of fun mini games. And then if you use up all your turns, you have to, I don't know, start over. You don't actually have to start over. You just have to, like, reload.
But again, there's all sorts of hidden stuff in this part too, right?
Right. So you check in with this guy. He gives you, like, sort of an assignment.
You'll never guess what happened. A friendly turtle hit my unicorns.
Oh, I hate it when that happens.
You need to become the right entities. So we need to... So he tells us that we have to, like, transform into these creatures.
Right.
To find his ultra coins.
And in your mini games, unless you run into an enemy, anything else you run into, like any other character or any other, like, animal, monster, thing, if you run into it, you become them and you enter into their mini game. So it's like layers of mini games.
Man.
You can either complete the one you're doing, or you can just run into another character and start their mini game.
Correct.
So it's super weird. And it's also really hard to keep track of what we've done and what we haven't done.
This makes perfect sense, I'm sure, for all of you.
Right?
In other news, there's the bot. So you reload your bonfire with logs. And this is all stuff that we had to figure out last time.
There's no instruction.
There's no guide here.
And there's no story. It's just like... This is what it is.
So the fire allows you to go back and kind of, like, restart this, like, droplet waterfall. The clock allows you to enter into a challenge to try and restart where you last left off.
Yeah.
And the soda-drinking turtle, straw turtle.
I thought he had... Oh, I thought that was a telescope. I thought that was, like, a little periscope he had on his shell.
No, it is a turtle with a straw sticking out of him.
Oh, he can just...
Ew. So he allows you, he's just like a guaranteed restart, but it burns out your bonfire.
Yeah.
So anyway, so we're going to try to do a clock here.
Oh boy.
I need to catch something in my mouth.
Have we done this one? Oh yeah.
Oh, shoot. Ah. It did not go through my mouth, so I failed.
Shoot.
So I have to try again.
Man.
I know. I
so every time you complete a minigame, one of your pictures gets filled in here. And again, just random information. Doesn't really connect to anything yet.
Yeah, aww. Nailed it. Got it. No, that counted. There we go.
It did?
Yeah, no, I'm in space.
Oh, come on.
So, and it is literally like WarioWare. I mean, that
So if we ran into that butterfly, for instance, we would enter into that butterfly thing.
Correct. Although I want to see what else we have.
Yeah, I want to complete this one. Ooh.
Right? We haven't completed space yet, have we?
I don't think so.
It doesn't look like it.
No. Okay.
Oh no!
Man,
that sucked. I was absolute garbage there. So anyway, that's the world of Soda Drinker Pro and Vivian Clark.
So there it is. I'll hop into the chat and see if I can answer any questions. The answer is no.
The answer is a definite yes, Steph.
Adriana Ziada's like, it's a sperm wall.
Can I? Ooh, I kind of want to face it.
Crimson Tail's like, OMG, right? Rosie the Wolf is like, la what? Let's see.
Guys, it's completely self-explanatory. Can I phase into him?
Right?
Okay, I did. So now I'm Space Jellyfish.
Bones 2005 says, all hail the water. What is in that soda, says Kingdom Hearts Gamer.
Oh, now I am Space Jellyfish on a space rock. Because obviously.
Isaac Hooter says, hi Matt and hi Steph.
Hey.
Hey. How do you? Oh, you're like a...
I'm a little space jellyfish.
Aw, that's so
against,
cute.
I don't know, like, they look. He looks evil.
Does he?
He looks like an evil Pikmin.
That's cute. You jumping on that guy?
I'm gonna try.
Aw, no.
How would I have known that that killed? That
it's really hard to tell the good guys from the bad guys.
So a lot of this game is trial and error, so thanks for like staying patient with us. Also, if you hop through this barrier, which it doesn't seem like you should, but if you hop through it, you'll actually get a, like, there's some mysterious godlike entity through there that just kills you.
Yeah, that's a thing too.
Hope you're all caught up now.
Right?
Welcome
Elliot Selesky says, pew, 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 pew. Alex Matthews says, what the heck is this? It's Soda Drinker Pro. It's not a game, it's a lifestyle. That's what the promotional material said.
Is that what it says?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that is what it said, isn't it? I remember that now.
The water looks like a ghost, says Chloe Cat. It does, actually. You could also be a ghost.
So the other thing to note about this, which is just wild, is each of these little mini-games or characters that you inhabit seems to have its own mission, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, and you're kind of trying to figure out the mission as you go. There are those little clues that you can buy from the store that'll kind of like, oh, do X task.
Sort of, but the last one we got was like really obvious.
Yeah,
some
of them are
more.
Look how
cute this guy is. He is so cute. Wait, did we finish the space one or not?
I feel like this is something important to me. It's not killing me, and I'm not absorbing it. So what am I doing here?
It's just a nice decoration. Okay. Oh, he doesn't look like he's good news.
No!
Oh no! Oh, jeez.
Okay. We're all right. But again, we don't have a clear idea of what we're
doing. Oh, hey, what's that?
That seems important.
Right?
Okay,
that was important. That meant something. Something real big.
And it's funny, because on the GT Live Archive channel, when people are watching, going back and watching this one again, people are like, why are you trying to solve it? Like, do you really think that this...
Whoa! Oh my gosh.
So I'm like a parachute, almost.
Sort of.
But people are like, why are you trying to solve it? Very clearly.
I think it's solvable is the thing. I think people don't think it's solvable.
There's a difference between randomness for randomness's sake and having it, like, this feels intentional.
It does.
And that's something that we deal with a lot when, you know, working on theories, is there are those moments where
we're in that one.
Which is just another tall poppy thing.
Okay. Oh boy.
Yeah, watch out.
This is like your mom's dress closet.
Clearly, see, like we just said, everything obviously makes total sense.
Ooh, obviously. Ooh.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's the currency with which you buy stuff.
Right. Yeah, that helps you buy more
logs,
time.
Right?
You are too tall for your own good there.
Oh, no. Oh, they move! Oh, poop. Okay.
Oh, there you go.
There.
Now what? Oh, there you go.
Assuming I have to go this way. It's all an exploration and putting together the mystery.
Because there are no rules. It also, everything is like, should you do it? Should you not do it? And there's no way to tell.
Transform into the cloud, I guess. Oh no, we're back to the top.
Ah.
Ah, okay. But now we know at least one of the loops, which is the loop goes
Mom's closet to Cloud from jellyfish, from space jellyfish.
Okay, so we go.
Okay, now we're into Rocket.
Yeah, so Rocket, which we also haven't done. We also haven't like solved yet.
Yeah, how did we get out of that one last time?
Well,
we died.
Well, we can either get absorbed into butterfly.
Yeah.
We can get absorbed into whatever that like weird.
Space jellyfish?
Yeah, space jellyfish was.
Let's avoid all that until we can get to the end of this one. No!
Oh, God! Every time! He doesn't give you like any sort of warning whatsoever. Okay, so I'm gonna buy a couple more clocks.
Alright.
So that way we can kind of restart there.
Darn it.
So anyway, tell us about the strangest game you've ever played.
Yeah. That'd
I'm
be
curious.
Cool. Let's see.
Because this ranks up there for me, honestly. Like, I like it a lot because it has so clear of like a, like there's just so many hidden details to it, which I really appreciate.
Right?
But it is weird.
Why is Gunnar Legion saying mature stream? If anything, this is kind of an immature stream. Oh!
Oh, I'm supposed to put him over at the end of this one.
Oh yeah, that's right.
There we go. So he is saved, we passed the test, we're back in space.
Okay.
Because obviously.
Obviously. Go like a different way. We seem to be...
Well, the purple guy... The purple guy! The purple guy comes out at you.
Always the purple guy.
Right? Something about the color purple.
He always seems to come from...
The right.
Yeah. The bottom right.
I think in order to complete this one, I have to shoot all the asteroids.
Oh!
Right. I think that's what this one is.
Really?
Shoot all asteroids.
Right? It doesn't, like, it's so hard to tell
okay,
if there's
space
okay,
jellyfish.
There's jellyfish. Come on. Oh, geez.
There he is.
There he is. Okay. Okay. Ooh. Oh, what was that thing?
That's,
oh my gosh.
That's an asteroid.
Oh man, we're getting closer. Maybe?
Right? Who knows? Who knows if we are getting closer? That is the question.
Right?
I feel like I've shot a lot of asteroids.
Come on.
Okay, I'm gonna go this way now.
Randomly.
Oh.
How far does that go?
Right? I feel like... Oh, there... We... Oh, no. We just got a... We got a Steam achievement. We
okay.
did not get an achievement in the game.
Aww.
Which is what we really want. Because we want to unlock all the different galleries.
Wait, did it just start over somewhere? Your screen just popped?
It is unclear. Well, now we're a butterfly. Because, once again, for reasons.
Come on, man.
And we did the push-ups before. So if you go into the house,
right.
you can do push-ups. That's why I wouldn't you?
Yeah, what else would you be doing in a house? All right, so don't get burned up.
No, you don't want to go into the fire?
No.
Okay. What's back here? What's this thing with the balloon? Oh, no. The controls. It's also worth noting, controls.
Oh, geez.
Not
oh, there's a present?
Oh, let's get the present. That seems important.
Oh, I want a present. Do it. It's a present!
Watch it.
Present!
Okay, we got it.
What does that do? Are we faster now?
I think.
Can we fly higher than we have ever flown before?
Yes, Stephanie. No, I think the point of this one is to collect all the presents.
Ah, okay.
I think that is.
I think that seems fair.
And
the depth perception is so weird.
The depth perception is a bit rough. The controls, equally rough. But I'm sure that the story hidden underneath it all is
so
totally gonna be worth it.
It.
It's basically FNAF. But
right.
Less scary.
Let's see. Person Hatsune says blame soda. Let's see.
This is all just one big tale of someone who's hyped up too much on caffeine.
Exactly. Is this what it's like to be addicted to Diet Coke?
I wouldn't know. I don't have that problem.
Sure.
And yes, the denial is part of what it means to be addicted to Diet Coke. Watch out for the line.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, here
Circle
we go.
Circle in on him. Circle in on him.
Here we go. Here it is. Yes!
Bam!
Okay.
Come on.
Oh my gosh, butterfly.
Get good at flying.
Ooh, hey. A little forest popping up around. Oh my gosh,
there are
so many presents! Oh, this is terrible.
Oh, why are there so many?
Oh, this is brutal. This game.
You sure you want that to be the goal of this level? Look how many there are. There are so many.
I have a feeling.
I'm going to have to hop into Twitter before you're done with it.
Oh, no, not Twitter.
God.
No, I am curious, though, what people are saying about what their favorite game is. Or what their weirdest game experience is.
So, for some reason, the chat has been especially vigorous in the last couple of days, and we've been crashing it more often. So I'm going to have to switch to a different browser. Hang on.
Lame.
I know.
Wait, watch out for mine. Come on. Go. No! This is so frustrating. Oh! Other weird games in my life that I've played, I would say. There was this game for, I think it was the Super Nintendo, called Plock.
Plock?
Plock.
Okay.
The tell me if any of you watching have heard of Plock. But basically, it was in the genre similar to, like, Rayman, where it's, like, the protagonist who has no arms and no legs, and who just has, like, fists and feet that hover there. So very similar to Rayman, except the difference was, one, the marketing campaign was really weird, because it was, like, all the different things that Plock could mean. So, like, the sound of a grapefruit hitting the kitchen floor. It's like, oh yeah, that really makes me want to buy a video game. Great.
Give life. This game requires your presence.
No. Why can I not get this one?
Oh my gosh!
What is wrong with this gift?
Give it.
Where's a marionette when you need one? There it is.
There.
Oh,
boom.
Thank goodness. Okay. There's another one. All right.
Jeez.
So this game Plock. But unlike Rayman, which, I don't know, creates this, like, fun, cute fantasy world. I love the Rayman games, by the way. But creates this, like, fun, cute fantasy world. Plock created this, like, dark, really scary atmosphere where you're being attacked by, like, whenever you would get hit by an enemy, you would actually lose one of your limbs permanently.
Oh.
And when your limbs are kind of a requirement for you to be able to attack enemies and stuff, you would have to, like, progress multiple levels before you would be able to get your arms back.
Oh, that sucks.
It was, yeah, so one, it was just, like, a really bad idea gameplay-wise.
So, like, I'm trying to envision games where you, like, you need your arms, like Castlevania. Or something like that. Where
yes! Castlevania!
No,
the game where you need an arm in order to use a whip.
Or I'm trying to...
Yes. Arms tend to be an important appendage
there
for
some,
any game.
There are some games
human,
with spells and stuff where you don't really need arms. Just sort of like... You just sort of like emit spells.
Yeah, Skyrim. You really don't need an arm.
No, not at all. I could totally no arm Skyrim.
You don't need arms.
No.
But anyway, no, but that's the...
That's the weirdest game you've ever played?
But like, and it was a scary game, too, because there were whole levels dedicated to fighting these giant, like, just mouth creatures. They were giant bodies with enormous red-lipped mouths and, like, just nasty teeth in them. It was a really disturbing game.
Did their teeth have a lot of plock? Is that one of the definitions?
Plock.
What happens when you don't brush your teeth for a while? Plock. I'm really curious about what other things they said were plock.
They came up with a lot of really goofy, weird explanations.
No, tell me, what was the best one you remember? Are there more trees that are growing back every time we open a present? Is that what's going on here?
I can't tell you. I can't tell you that I missed this one, though. I hope that getting these presents means something, because otherwise...
Honestly.
This is just frustrating.
Right?
Okay.
Come on.
If getting these presents results in not accomplishing anything, I will be so sad. It will be tragic. My gosh, get out of the way, mines. Come on! No!
Oh, why?
Damn you and your 2D graphics! Oh!
Oh, come on. Oh, jeez.
I was on top of that present. Man.
Nope, you're gonna miss it again.
I know!
You're too far up.
Yes, thank you.
This is like doing heart surgery. Why is this so specific?
It's like surgeons and simulator.
Surgeon simulator.
Come on! Come on, game! No! What is this?
Soda, like, throwing off your depth perception.
Okay. Thank goodness. Man, tell you what.
At CornyGirl26 is like, impeccable depth perception.
This game better have the most satisfying conclusion.
Hardest game ever.
I am hyping this game up so much.
Oh, at Exotic Margarine says, strangest game ever played, Pico Sim Date Less Than 3.
Ah, Pico Sim Date Less Than 3?
Oh,
classic.
One of our favorites, yes.
What? Yeah, that was a favorite. Back when we were doing all sorts of dating sims.
Mm-hmm.
That's on GT Live if you haven't checked out Pico Sim Date Less Than 3.
Right?
Definitely worth your
time. That was in our dating sim phase when we did several. We did a little bit of Asagao Academy. We did Pico Sim Date Less Than 3.
We can use a couple more dating sims.
Oh, yeah.
If you guys have recommendations. We're always looking for a nice date.
Did we do Honey?
We did not do Honey Pop.
Honey Pop? There we go.
Everyone else did Honey Pop.
I was like, I don't think it's Honey Pop.
We could not do Honey Pop because it's a live stream.
That even the ones we did do, Jason had to do some creative censoring to make sure that we could actually play the game. Those are intense.
Yeah, there are definitely some dating sims out there that you're like, oh wow, that is not PC.
This is funny. At Justin LLP, hey, let's see. So at first I thought that Justin on Twitter was suggesting to us that we play a couple of games. He suggested Until Dawn and Life is Strange, but actually he's suggesting to the rest of the GT Live community, if you're newer to the live streams, what you should watch.
Ooh.
That's kind of cool.
Those are some classics.
Oh yeah, Until Dawn was great and Life is Strange was also a lot of fun. Those are pretty long playthroughs too. Let's see. At Roses K17, the strangest game I played was Battle Cat. It's a great game, but a little odd.
Battle Cat.
My strangest game was Mystic Towers. It was a DOS game from 1995, and it was another one with really bad depth perception. You had to you could only use the arrow keys.
What is this?
Oh hey buddy.
Maybe we can phase into him next. I'm curious about what he does.
Right?
There's a couple more presents we have to collect, though. I'm determined.
Yeah.
I am filled with determination!
Right, go!
In the words of Undertale. Anyway, sorry. So, what is it? So, Mystic Tower?
Mystic Towers. It was like a classic, like, go through levels of a castle and kill monsters and stuff like that. But it was... It was just kind of poorly designed. But also...
All the best ones.
The music was super weird. Like, the first several levels were really fun, but it was also... Like, the music was so strange. And so you just got, like, this really uncomfortable, eerie feeling whenever you would play it. It was very weird. I got most of the way through it. Mystic Towers.
Was it, like, a platformer where you collected a bunch of...
It wasn't necessarily a platformer. It was one of those... I'm trying to think of... It was actually... It was probably closest to like a Zelda, where you're going through the early Zelda, where you're going through like the dungeons and stuff, yeah. And like you're walking along pathways and it's just like black space underneath you and stuff.
Yeah,
it was that kind of thing. But it was really clunky because you had to use the arrows on your keyboard, and then to hit a monster you had to be like facing the right way, but like the screen was diagonal, but you only had like up, down, left, right arrows, and so they had to like you had to like translate what you were putting in to like what was actually happening on the screen. It was very weird. It was a weird game.
You should play it on the live stream.
Yeah. I don't know.
No, not super compelling.
It was.
I mean, then again, I am trying to float into presence.
Right.
For the last 15 minutes on the expectation of getting some level of reward, but I don't know.
At Lost 7011.
Oh, come on!
Captain Talion on Twitter says, when your mom walks in on you watching this and you're trying to explain.
It is, right?
Hey,
good luck.
Yeah, have fun with that one.
2016's most controversial game, that's all you guess is.
Whoa, at Autumn Frosty, the weirdest games I've played probably LSD Dream Simulator.
I've wondered
about
that one.
You guys should play it, it's an experience.
I've wondered about LSD Dream Simulator, actually. That's one that I've heard about.
You order it online and you open up the box and it comes with like Here are your syringes. Here are your
Stephanie, okay. Come on. LSD. Yeah, you better be kidding, because everyone knows that LSD comes in tablet form or as a little sheet of paper that you put on your tongue.
I was about to say, I thought it's like a breath strip.
It's like a breath strip. I know that because I did a report in sixth grade about LSD, not because of any other reasons.
It's fair to learn about it through research and through Breaking Bad. I feel like those are the two legitimate ways to learn about...
Breaking Bad doesn't do LSD.
No, but they do meth.
Come on, Steph, different world. Get your drugs straight.
Sorry, I don't know the intricacies, yo.
Get good, Steph.
Get good at drugs. Don't do that. Don't listen to that. Don't do that.
Come on!
That's a really bad idea.
No, actually, fun fact, though, about that LSD project, it was one of the, like, straws that broke the camel's back when it came to me and group projects. I
thought you were going to say, and drug addiction.
Well, no. Yes, it was one of the straws that broke the camel's back.
That sixth grade self, where you were like, I gotta stop doing this. Look at what this report says is gonna happen to me.
It's true. It really got me to question my life decisions about, you know, the amount of drug use I had in my life at the time. true story.
I'm just taking so much Benadryl for these allergies. I gotta cut back.
I gotta dial it back, man. It's starting to affect me. No, so true story. What ended up happening was the teacher knew that I was, like, I don't know, the overachiever in class. And so she partnered me with the three people who were, like, the bottom of the barrel of the class. And I mean that in the
judgy,
nice way.
Judgy.
No, she partnered me with the people who always, like, didn't succeed at their group projects. Like, they were the bad team members,
maybe,
right?
Maybe they were trying so hard.
No, they weren't. That was the point. That was the point.
I'm giving you a hard time. I actually have the exact same feeling about group projects. So, go ahead.
I was partnered with, like, the dead weight, as it were.
Don't be dead weight in group projects. People remember it, like, years later.
And so what ended up happening, so I'm partnered with the dead weight, right? I'm also still looking for balloons. That's why I'm not trying to phase into anything. I'm partnered with the dead weight, and we even, like, schedule, okay, we're going to meet at the library, back when meeting at the library was a thing. We're going to meet at the library to work on this thing on Saturday because we got to get it done. No one showed up. Except, and this is where the story kind of takes an interesting turn. Except for one kid who showed up 20 minutes late, so be it. But he showed up. Interesting thing to note about this kid, though, he was the bully who had, like, literally picked on me.
Really?
Which was another reason why I was super thrilled about this project, right? Because it's like the teacher partnered me up with the guy who tried to de-pants me in the hallway earlier in the year.
Did she know that?
No, probably not.
There's a little golden thing over there.
Yes, I see the golden thing over there. I'm going to try to get the golden thing. I feel like I've gotten all the balloons. Yeah. I'm not seeing any more balloons.
There is apparently no achievement for all of those balloons.
There's got to be an achievement for the balloons. So anyway, this guy tried to de-pants me earlier in the year. And, of course, joy of joys, he ends up being one of the four people in this group project that I'm doing. But he showed up 20 minutes late on the day, and he was the only person to show up. It's the weekend. I have given up my weekend to work on this stupid LSD project. And he shows up. And so from that day forward, he and I had a newfound respect for each other, and he didn't pick on me.
Really? He didn't pick on you anymore?
No, actually.
Oh, that's good. I was about to say, did he just go on to de-pants you in the library and then steal all your work?
He did. He did steal the work. He didn't add too much to the project, but I respected the fact. I'm like, hey, I'm willing to put in the work for you, kid, because you actually showed up.
Wait. You're willing to do a whole project for someone just because...
Steph, I was dealing with the bottom of the barrel. Here's the thing. I was going to end up doing the whole project anyway. So I did it. So, you know, I did it for him. Doing it for him was better because he showed up and actually...
Doing it to someone who literally tried to take your pants down in the middle of school.
Steph, he showed up, okay?
Who grabbed you...
It's the thought that counts.
...by the buns.
There was no grab by the buns. And luckily for me, I wear belts, and so the belt saved the day. Pro tip, if you're getting picked on in school...
sixth grader belt.
If you're getting picked on in school, wear belts.
Wear a belt.
Wear Also, there's got to be another gift. I had to have gotten something for doing all the gifts, right?
You gave gifts.
Okay. Now give me an achievement. Give gifts, give achievement. I don't know where it is.
Come on.
This is.
You can collect some nice ice crystals or something.
Maybe there's a gift at the top of that tall central tower. Doesn't appear to be. I don't know what to do.
This is a silly game.
Tis a silly game. Alright, let's phase into a green head.
Alright.
That's what we're gonna do. Because that makes perfect sense.
Man!
I know, I thought the gifts were gonna lead to something.
Life.
Oh! Oh, because why would we be able to phase into the giant green floating head?
Wait, he's just there?
Apparently so!
Dude!
Come on, green head.
Frankenstein, buddy, come on!
Wait, he said thank you.
He did?
He says thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
What
does it mean? Here you go, buddy.
Land on your face.
Thank you. You're welcome. Break it
down. What do you do?
You want to face through him?
I know. Why won't...
He's avoiding me. Let me touch
totally...
him with my butterfly goodness. With my beautiful butterfly-ness. Touch,
touch me! No,
touch my body! Touch my soft, delicate butterfly body!
Oh my gosh! He's just like Matrix style. He's like, no!
Kiss me! Butterfly kiss! What? Come on! This butterfly level... He's good!
Oh.
He's like a matador.
Right?
He's like the matador of butterflies.
Alright, I think we have to go elsewhere.
I think. Yes. That is probably accurate.
So where was that other place that we didn't go into yet?
There's that big castle.
Yeah, let's go into the big castle.
I'm gonna go into the big castle. one more attempt.
Alright.
Oh,
at Frosty right, Game Maker blames Jason for the poor depth perception in this game.
I think that is an accurate
Jason
blame.
Jason has actually just completely abandoned this live stream.
Jason, Jason ran away.
He's just like...
Bravely ran away,
napping
away.
Somewhere. God.
Brave Sir Jason!
At HelloPerson9101 says, you can forget Pony Island.
Oh.
Oh, hey, what? What happened here? Did we just flip over to the other side? How'd we get here?
I got stabbed by someone.
What?
I got stabbed by someone through the box that I was kept in. Oh, we did unlock one.
Okay, good.
What do we unlock? What do we unlock, game? Please. Yeah! The butterfly!
Oh,
we did it!
Oh,
thank goodness. Holy cow. That was really challenging.
Jeez.
That was brutal.
Man.
All right. So now we're going to go back, hopefully. Stab! Yes, swordfish.
Awesome!
Okay, so I get dropped off here. I gotta hit the boxes.
Oh, jeez.
Okay, watch out for being stabbed.
Yeah, oh my gosh.
Hit it!
Can you... There we go. Okay, this one. Two? Is that two?
That hit all of them.
Oh, it did. Okay, ooh.
Ooh, I got the teleporter box now.
Whoa!
Or something. Come on. There you go.
It's just a fizzy soda. What is this?
What is this? Uh-oh!
Oh, we've seen that guy before.
Yeah, we've seen him. Ooh, look at this red area that I don't know. What should I touch or not touch? Bad touch game!
Right?
Bad touch. Here, I'm gonna phase into this red... Alright, I touched the red thing, and...
This blue platform has so many skin tags. It's very weird.
Okay, here we go. Oh!
It opened that up.
Okay, so I gotta touch the red box.
Alright. Oh, that don't touch Wormy.
Don't touch the like turbine.
Or, right?
And don't touch the cloud, because the cloud will send us back up to the top.
Yeah.
We know that. At this
oh
point.
Yeah. Awesome.
Okay.
Whoa.
Don't touch wind turbine. Oh, that's the final boss! Something. Woo! Oh no!
No! Oh, we fell on turbine-y. Oh.
Screw you, turbine!
God. Can we go back?
I will do my best.
Shoot.
We'll buy a couple of clocks here.
Yeah. Turtles.
No, clocks. Not turtles. I don't want... Because turtles burn through your bonfire.
It does.
Which
okay.
you don't want... So basically, you don't want to burn through your bonfire ever. That's the moral of the story, which makes perfect sense, obviously. Right?
Oh, I like this. Someone at Ben.
We got another one.
Oh yes. At Ben Steeman on who is Eisenbold on Twitter says Breaking Pat instead of Breaking Bad. It's just Breaking Pat. What's that one?
That was the like phase. That was the touch the switches to phase into the box.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So here we go. We're filling it out slowly. Oh, this one. So this one, you have to hop into the water, droplets that he throws.
Yeah! Nice.
I've gotten pretty decent at
that. Oh, yeah. You're an old pro at the old jump into the water droplet.
Okay, where's Turbine? There's Turbine.
Run away!
Where is Turbine? Where is Turbine? There he is. All right.
It's like a nice little food processor. Oh, man, he's coming for you.
Right? He's a little slap and chop.
Right?
Okay, here we go.
He slices. He dices.
Okay, here we go. This one's fast.
They like sell him on an infomercial.
All right, here's the last thing. All right. I think.
Are you sure?
Oh no. Oh no.
What do we do now?
Where am I supposed to go? Where is it? Where is the final box?
No.
No. What the? No. No. I fall into the abyss.
How are we supposed to do that?
What? Where was it?
Come
Wait. Maybe. Oh, I didn't unlock it. Shoot.
Darn it.
What was I supposed to do?
Are there two on one of them?
Yeah, let's try this again.
Alright.
Nailed it. Alright. So what did I do wrong that time? Ooh, there's a little black hole there now. What is this? I'm curious. Let's touch
it. Let's do it. We unlocked black hole.
Oh, I'm the water droplet. I'm the water droplet evaporating.
I think you're a wafting bit of fuzz.
Nope, water droplet.
No, you totally came off of a sweater.
Ooh.
You're a wafting
jet
bit
engine.
Of fuzz. Whoa! What is this angle?
What is that?
What?
Now we're in the ejector seat. And now we're what is this game? What the heck? Oh no!
That little water droplet was giving you a bit of a look. Look at that judgmental eye.
Stop giving me that look,
you
water droplet.
You couldn't even parachute, man. God.
You don't know what this game is about. All right, let's buy a couple clocks. I don't know.
All right, while you're resetting, at Reader1229 says, Matt Pat, the same thing happened for a music project where I did the whole thing and they got mad when I didn't include them. That's the other thing. Like,
right?
there's always
satisfied.
Some participatory, like, teamwork thing involved.
It's not my fault to carry the rest of the group.
I know. I have the same experience with this project, actually.
Yeah. Okay. So anyway, no, I'm glad to hear that other people have difficult experiences with this. Because seriously, like,
right.
And teachers are, it is, it's the thing of like, oh, you didn't include everyone. It's not my fault that they didn't want to be included.
Right, exactly.
Nor is it my job to carry them in the subject. I'm sorry. Like, you know, I can only go so far, teach. I'm already dealing with the way too much homework that you're giving me.
The thing is, I think sometimes teachers are like, oh, they won't, kids don't notice. They won't know, like, the strategy behind this. We get it. Like, you don't have to be very old to figure out, like, hey, some people work hard, some people don't, so.
Right? Welcome to the world, man.
No. It's called the jump. Just give it a little hippie hop. There you go. Whoa.
Wow, look at that platform right there.
Oh, jeez.
That is rough. I'm just gonna try to hop over to this thing.
Oh,
nice. Yes!
And better news, you have so many nice legs. Oh, jeez.
Oh, come on!
No.
Oh,
I can't tell if I'm making any progress.
Steph, we're making the most progress.
Are we making any progress?
So much progress, Stephanie.
Are you sure?
We've entered a really difficult section, okay? We got a couple of gallery things opened. Oh, shoot, I didn't want to buy a turtle.
At Nate DeForest also sent in on Twitter. His weirdest game was a game called Brief Karate Foolish. It's a Japanese fighting game. That sounds awesome. Brief Karate Foolish.
It sounds like a Japanese fighting game.
Right?
Brief Karate Foolish. Sorry.
At Smoofby says, this game is a soda executive's mind while developing a new ad campaign.
Right? This is like something Sprite cooked up.
Right?
The uncoolest. No! Oh, leave me alone! Damn it! Oh, sucks! Oh, and my bonfire went down. And I'm in a section of the game where, like, you don't get as many of the little pop icons. Shoot.
Oh, man. At HaleyG129, upon Googling Plock, it seems cute. Explain yourself.
Plock seems cute. It seemed like a game that I would have liked, honestly.
It's a plocky little game.
That's why I was really disappointed when I found out that it was really just kind of like dark, disturbing. The gameplay mechanics of it weren't too solid. Just across the board.
The sound of a feather coming out of a bird. Plock.
No!
Not you, honestly.
What? I hate to break it to you. The platforming on this game, not the most precise. When I try to, like, maneuver gently so I don't fall off the damn level. Sorry, Grandma. I know that you watch sometimes and you get upset when I say the word damn.
Don't worry. I can keep coming up with lots of Plock jokes, but you gotta...
Plock. The sound of a clock that is... Whoa. Shoot! Well, that was garbage. What was I supposed to do? Oh my gosh. This is taking a turn for the worst, friends. This is taking a dark turn. What if I go this way? What if I go backwards toward the camera? I'm gonna try that. Literally nothing. Thanks. Thanks, game. What else is over there? If I take a right, there seems to be more things.
Rory Turing gets into the passive-aggressive ways of demonstrating which of your team members contributed to a project.
Oh, yes, let's talk about that, because I have all sorts of strategies about that.
At Cannibal Candy is the Twitter handle. I had a project for philosophy of religion. Three of us did the work. One did zilch. We made it clear when we did the credit slide.
Yes, yes, that's the way to go.
Yes, that it is.
I was hot. This is brutal. This is brutal. I'm sorry. Right? The credit slide by taking more of the presentation. I would do all sorts of stuff.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Because at a certain point, your goodwill can only go so far, right?
You gotta stand up for the work that you've done.
You do.
At Southern Jedi says, "Great. I just realized I have a project while watching this."
I apologize for that.
Yeah. Well, either that or
you've been leaning on your teammates,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, have you been leaning on your teammates there, friend?
Leaning on your teammates a little bit. Okay, here we go. Okay.
Let's see. What was the last group project you did? Because I had group projects. Like, I hate to break it to you guys. The group projects never end. In fact, in grad school, I probably had more group projects than in most of college. It's a bit of a bummer.
That is a bummer.
But by the time you get to grad school, you're actually working with people who like really want to be there. And they're really like dedicated to what they're doing. So by then it's a pretty even playing field, or like it should be. There was one person in my grad school class who is still total dead weight.
Really?
Yeah, one person.
No! Ah! Come on! The jump mechanic. Oh. Okay.
But at least there's only one, and you can kind of try and avoid them a little bit at that point. But yeah, it never ends. So what was the last group project you ever did?
Honestly, the last group project I probably did was yours, the one with you.
And you still have a bad taste about group projects in your mouth.
No.
Because we've done group projects. Like, Matthew and I have done group projects. And you're still like, oh, I hate group projects. Great.
You're saying,
I was not the dead
man
in that project.
No, you weren't. That was one of the things that, like, I was like, wow, I'm really impressed by how awesome you are. Like, you were the first you were the first partner that I had in a group project that wasn't absolute, like, garbage.
Yes.
No.
Not absolute garbage.
Oh, I didn't want to buy him. Sorry. I have more than enough soda drinking turtles. I have 11. Oh, this is brutal. Sorry, guys. I'm letting you down.
We're gonna get through this.
So are we any closer to discovering the mysteries of this game, Steph?
We're so close right now. I feel it. Any second, the whole thing is going to crystallize, and we're going to understand exactly what's going on here.
The whole mystery of this game is going to come together. It's going to be an amazing moment.
Something tells me that might not be the case. God, there's a lot. There's a lot.
There's a lot in this game. So, and we said, like, you know, the developer had sent us an email, like, thanking us for playing the game.
Yeah.
He was glad to see that someone enjoyed it. But the thing about it was like, oh yeah, there's a reason it's 6 gigs. So there's a lot of game here.
It's a big game.
There's a lot of game that's hidden. Come on!
Oh no!
Come on!
Look, he jigs all the way to the bottom.
That's good.
I want to jig to my death when that day comes.
At Eames Bjorn Bear says, because screw you, Turbine, and send a picture of a turbine that says screw you, Turbine, on it.
It's words.
Yes.
Words to live by.
At Acapella Fine says, OMG, my first, actually for, they said the first live stream. Ooh. I think it might be first live stream.
Welcome from Final Fantasy VII.
But welcome, yeah, I was about to say, if you've played Final Fantasy VII, welcome from the live stream as well. It's 2 a.m. here.
Wow.
Oh, and they're hashtag notification squad.
Hey!
They're part of the notification squad. Woo woo!
Woo, welcome. Yeah. Notification squad. Oh, no. Can I absorb this guy? What are you thinking here?
What? No!
There's disappearing platforms behind him, too!
No!
Ah! Yes, I threw a pillow. Because that's what my soul told me to do in that
moment.
Man. Brutal! Absolutely brutal.
This level is really hard.
This level has so many different pathways.
Do we need to have a talk about this?
This is rough. This is rough, friends. This is rough.
Seriously, man.
Rough times. Come on, soda drinking turtle. So apparently I picked probably the hardest pathway.
Oh man, we're also getting some shade from Spicy Meme Fountain.
Oh no.
Spicy Meme Fountain on Twitter. Please, the Legend 27 beat this game. Beat this game's patootie.
Oh man.
They did not say patootie.
The Legend 27 also doesn't cite dead memes. Oh, memes that have been filtered to you by corporate entities.
What?
Legend 27 is a meme that was like basically created by Game of War.
Really? I didn't know that.
The game, yes. Huh. It came from a commercial and they just like spammed the heck out of it online.
Huh.
And so, I mean, hey, they did a great job of doing it, you know, because a lot of...
Oh, come on.
Welcome to Rage Game Tuesday, everyone.
I was about to say, Chris, got any Diet Coke back there or anything?
I need an emotional Diet Coke, my friends.
Oh, the fridge is stocked.
Wait, there's
excellent.
A Diet Coke? You bought me a Diet Coke? I told you. Oh, it's leftover. So, fun fact. I'm trying to...
Ooh, did you know there's tomatoes in here, too?
Hey.
There's tomatoes?
What?
Wait, there's tomatoes?
What?
Should I be worried about the produce that's in... What launched me off of that? No! No! So anyway, I'm trying to reduce my soda intake because I recognize that, like... I have a crippling addiction to it.
What?
So I'm trying to dial it back a little bit. I'm reducing myself to 3 sodas a day as opposed to 6 or more. Healthy New Year's resolutions, everybody.
Hey, man.
I'm still not giving it up because it's just good and tastes good and stuff. And I need it. But
I can quit anytime,
okay? All right.
You could have some nice Canada Dry. I'm enjoying it. Mm. It's pretty nice. Mm.
Diet ginger ale.
It's so good. Ginger ale is the best.
Okay, here we go. Let's try this again. Should I jump into this guy?
It seems really hard.
Okay, here it is. I passed it! I passed it! Ah! Pity Diet Coke. I'm allowed 3 a day. This is number 2, okay? Don't judge me.
Cheers.
Did we savor it?
know, right? That was a really big gulp.
It's not gonna last long that way, friend.
It's doing fine. It's doing fine, okay? Thank you very much. I'll savor my Diet Coke in the way that I deem fit. Keep calm and drink Diet Coke.
So good.
My
Diet Drill is great, I'm just telling
more
you.
More of a Schweppes man myself.
I am too, to be honest, but that's okay.
I'm good. Also, it was funny, speaking of Diet Coke, it was funny. So we, on Twitter, we posted a video from CES where I was drinking a soda and everyone's like, oh my gosh, he's drinking a Pepsi.
Oh yeah.
A Diet Pepsi. It's like, hey, you take what you gotta get. Like, I'm Diet Cola agnostic. You know, if they have Pepsi, like, not everyone.
Oh, my gosh. Just a little hopperoo.
Yeah, it's a lot shorter than you expect it to be.
Just a little hippie hop.
Man,
there we go.
I'm supposed to get all the way across this thing. There's no way. There's no way.
Okay.
You're doing great.
Look how nicely done this is.
This is brutal. Right? I like jump and I'm like, there's no reason why.
Okay.
What do I?
I can't tell. I can't even tell what's close. Oh god.
I have to like jump down. Yes. No!
What are you thinking?
No! This game is breaking me. Platforms be tripping!
Jeez.
So true, Steph. Platforms be tripping. Alright.
Alright, it's fine.
God.
What
was your New Year's resolution, Steph?
My New Year's resolution? I had several, actually. And we haven't talked about this on the stream at all, actually. This is a really good topic. My New Year's resolution was to not eat as much dessert. Because I have a huge sweet tooth, and not like there.
No!
It was so close! No!
This game. I want to solve the mysteries of this game, but game, you have to be playable for me to solve the mysteries of you.
It's all about the deep breath.
Deep breath. Soda drinker pro, you're making me hate soda.
What? This was the cure for your addiction. This is it. That's actually the point of the game. If you have a soda addiction, this is how to break it.
Clearly what it is.
This is it. We figured out the mystery of soda drinker pro.
Get out of here. No. No. Just say no. Okay, good. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nope. Up. Okay. Here. Up. 2. No! I did the giant reorient myself. Ooh, the rage hair is coming up strong with this one. The rage hair is coming out strong today. I just want to beat one of these things.
I know, right? Come on. There better be something really good that we learn at the end of this level, too. At Cass Winchester says, hashtag DT Live, the Mad Pat moment has come.
It is strong. Welcome back to 2017. First Mad Pat moment. Okay.
Diet Pat says, Ben Steenan, and...
1, 2, 3. Here, I'm gonna stay
here.
Disappear. No! Okay. So you really just gotta go for it. There is no time to wait there. You just have to go.
You just gotta go.
Okay.
No.
Are you ready?
Yeah, dude. You got this.
I'm feeling it. Dear game designers who are designing platformers, Make depth perception just a
thing.
A skosh.
Make it a thing.
A skosh easier.
No, just make it exist at all.
Because right now, I have
and
to
look,
judge
with
everything.
All, with all those legs, you just can't manage to land on a thing down there.
Well, because at this point, I have to judge everything off of my shadow, which is wouldn't be so bad if like the controls were a little less floaty. Oh my gosh, okay.
Ready, go.
Okay,
go.
good.
Yes!
Oh, don't you even. Don't you even. What is this?
Come on.
Okay.
This is blind.
I cannot.
What is this?
And for any of you who are like, why aren't you changing the camera angle? I cannot.
It doesn't change. It's fixed. Ugh. Okay.
Okay, wait.
One, two, four, three. Okay, five, six. And then where does it go?
Up. Just goes up.
Just goes up.
Okay. Okay. Jump. Oh no, not into the cloud! I don't want to be the cloud!
Ugh.
No! I don't want to be the cloud! Here, I'll be a balloon instead.
You've already done it!
Here, I'll be balloon.
Balloony?
That thing looks evil and like it'll kill me.
He's so deflated, like
right,
my spirit.
Hey, at least we're in a new section. That's all I care about. I am out of that stupid...
He doesn't even float.
Right, he's the saddest of balloons.
He's the saddest balloon.
The saddest.
He's like, you know how when you like start blowing up a balloon and it gets caught in that just like one
that
first...
like slightly deflated state.
Yeah, in that slightly deflated state. That's him.
That's him. The saddest balloon.
He's just little. He's our
this?
Little deflate gate.
What is this? What is this? Should I go into this? Again.
I'm a bit concerned about that.
Let's do it. Great!
What?
Makes perfect sense.
Ooh, it's all falling down.
Right? Ooh.
Oh geez.
Oh,
it's really falling
now
down.
Now they're shooting at me.
What? Why?
There's
why
something
are
glowing
you,
over there.
Why are
though.
They doing that? Ugh!
There's something glowing over there.
Okay.
I feel like I gotta get them to shoot at the glowing thing.
Oh yeah, look.
Okay. Yeah, or each other. Come on, shoot at me.
Come on, go.
Shoot at me, bro.
It doesn't look like they can hurt each other.
And it also doesn't seem like that guy's gonna, like, move out of the way. Oh! Like, oh, I need to get into that glowy thing. Ah! Alright.
Darn it!
Don't worry, we have plenty of soda-drinking turtles to spare. So we can hop back into it.
Right?
I can buy lumber, yeah.
Yeah.
Necessary.
At YT Trashcan says, Matt needs a hug.
I wonder what the goal of this mission is.
Right? Ooh, oh, wait. It's behind there. That's it. Get back there. Maybe you can just run around.
Yes!
Yes!
I think that did it.
Okay.
Or something.
Oh, we're back.
Oh, we're back here.
We're back here.
We already did this one, kind of.
But it's not...
But there's a different
solvable.
Guy over there in the corner now.
Yeah, that's true. Do you want to hop down?
Yeah, let's... I'm going to hop down and I'm
as
just
going
to swap
go.
Into...
As far as
we can go. Yeah, I'm going to swap into that guy who's down at the bottom level.
Yeah.
Am I supposed to... Maybe I talk to these guys. I guess not.
No.
Oh.
Whoa, this is one we haven't done.
Ooh. There's all these switches
it's
around,
cousin
too.
It. Yeah, right? Right, what do they do?
Oh, this is no bueno.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, this is, yeah, that's, nah. That ain't a good one. Wait, up, now we're human walking bridge. I'm gonna go walk backwards, though.
What?
And hop into the obviously the are you kidding
honestly.
Me I was supposed to squeeze my way through that all right without touching anything did we unlock anything no
oh come Ooh. On
soda drinker pro today is a bit frustrating
right this is
okay
go around the edge yep you got this totally got this dude there you go.
Wow.
Okay.
The changing
straight
perspective
through the middle.
Is
there you go.
Tricky. Yes! Yes!
Change the controls too.
It does. Come on. What do you got coming for me? What is this? This is a good thing.
Cotton candy!
Come to me, cotton candy! Oh. Hey! Look
oh,
where we're back
guy.
To.
Oh, this guy. Okay.
I feel like that would have unlocked something, right?
Right? Yeah, that has to.
Because we completed the mission.
Right.
Last time, last time we went up.
So now...
Well, it looks like we still have to go up.
So
that makes
fine. All right, fine. Did we finish this one? I just can't remember which ones we finished. Because
we have not
like,
finished. We exited this one, but we did not finish
okay, it. Okay, well, let's try and finish
yes,
it this
I agree.
Time.
Which means we have to go back this way.
Yeah.
Which means we're going this way.
Okay.
Okay.
Those spiky rods are so very spiky.
Hey, as long as we got the butterfly achievement, I'm happy.
Right, I know.
That was a big one.
That was a big one.
Okay. Okay, we gotta hop up onto that thing, I'm assuming. Oh! Oh! Yes!
Good one. Yeah!
That was tight. That was a tight jump. Okay.
Watch out for those things appearing behind you, the big ones.
Okay, here we go. Woo! Okay, keep climbing up. It's like a stairway to heaven.
It's always gonna be another mountain.
Okay, these are the ones that rotate.
Okay. Nice.
Man, when it's not in a forced, like, 3D, 2.5D perspective, it's so much easier to platform.
It's so very possible.
Go figure. Oh!
Oh, it's a button!
Stand in the basket and collect and present 500 collects.
What?
I know it.
I know.
Aww.
Sure, and I didn't unlock any.
Come on.
Soda Drink a Pro. Don't do this to me, bro.
Seriously,
bro. Don't do this to me, Soda Drink a Pro, bro.
Come on, bro.
Bro. Pro.
Come on, pro, bro.
Pro, bro. Don't do it to me, pro, bro. Okay. So I need 500 of those.
They're, oh, which is probably
dots.
Why they give you so many in this level.
Yeah, but still, like,
that's,
there's no
way
we're getting
500. That's way
too many. If I get crushed.
You just get juiced.
Right, I was gonna say, I wonder if getting juiced is something, you know?
How many does that give you? Ugh.
Not enough.
Great, only 100 more of those needed.
Ugh. Whopping 5.
Man.
I know, this is brutal. This is tough. We might, at some point, we might have to do part of this game off the stream.
I know.
Just so we can
get to a point where we can
show off what we've learned.
Yeah, and start making
wild hypotheses and or theories.
Right? Because right now this is like fever dream meets kids drawing.
Is there anything there?
I think so.
Right? It feels like there is. Oh! Nope.
Maybe from one further down. That one. Yeah.
Oh, almost. Man. Wait, try again. So close. Oh! Yes!
Yeah!
And literally nothing to show for it. Damn. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Be here.
Lame.
Be here all afternoon. I believe you supported
the only blame around here goes straight to Jason.
It ain't the same without the blame. Blame Jason.
Blame Jason.
So, hey, hop into Twitter. Let's prompt it. Since
I'm
making very little progress, let's prompt a discussion via social. Did anyone solve what the background is, by the way?
The background of this?
Oh, no, the background code.
Oh, back there? Not as far as I know. Let's see. Ooh. So we want to talk about what does it do up here?
This guy's a turtle.
It's a turd.
Stand in the basket and present 500 collects. That's all you can do.
Man. Oh, Jacob Zootopia says, more like soda drinking troll. Oh, sick burn. That was a sick burn.
That was pretty sick,
that
bro.
That was a totally sick burn.
Well done. Well done, sir. Tip of the cap to you.
At Only for GT Live, Steph singing The Climb is my new favorite thing. Gotta break out a little Miley every once in a while,
man. She just speaks to you, you know?
I know, right? Straight to my soul.
That red will go.
At Loathing C says, a little frustrating. Matt, it's okay to say the truth once. We know you're really mad. The thing is, I like the game.
I like the game a lot.
And you don't want to feel super frustrated when, like, you like the game. Why are we playing this level again?
Because I'm going out the alternate exit.
Oh, okay.
Because I don't want to, like, restart everything.
Yeah.
Exactly. I just want to go out the alternate. So, no, the thing is, yeah, like Steph said, I find this game fascinating. Yeah, the controls are bad. And this is one thing, like, people get really upset about bad controls in games. I don't know. I get used to them. I come from when you play it on the NES, and I played like any game that came my way, you get used to really bad controls, and so everyone like, oh, the controls suck. It's like, yeah, they do, but you get used to it, and right. A lot of times there's a good game under there, as long as you're able to like deal with the controls.
Sometimes it's worth it. I have an unpopular opinion.
This just actually launches me back up, right?
One of my unpopular gaming opinions is that I wasn't a big fan of Twilight Princess because I would get really frustrated with the controls for the Wii. Yeah. So for that one, it was like I want to like this game so much, but I just found the controls really annoying. And I know that everyone else like.
Oh, this is Flappy Bird.
Didn't.
Oh, this is.
Totally oh yeah.
Flappy Bird. Twilight Princess for the Wii with the motion controls.
Yeah, with the motion controls, I just didn't. I didn't like it. Like, it really took me out of the game to have to deal with the motion controls and trying to, like, fix the perspective all the time, so.
You know, honestly, I can, is that unpopular? Because for me, I liked Twilight Princess. I would agree, though, I was more of a fan of Twilight Princess when it came to the traditional control setup than I was of the motion controls. I don't know. I think that makes sense. I don't hate you for that. I can respect that opinion.
Let's see, I'm also going to come over into the chat for a little while. Let's see.
What is over here? Look at all these, like, munchers in the distance. Off in the distance, there's a beautiful horizon.
Ooh, what's that one from? I don't recognize that one.
No?
No. Aw.
What was I supposed to...
Game.
Game. Game. Game. Game. Oh, we unlocked another one, though.
Woo! What? Now we unlocked one?
Right? What do we get? Oh, the pelican.
Oh, nice.
Even That's though we cool. died, we got Flappy Bird.
All right, fair enough.
Huzzah! That was from You're in Town.
Oh, okay. Good musical, all about pee.
The song Look at the Sky. It's literally, in case you haven't heard of You're in Town,
actually,
it's a great
I guess,
musical.
I really did think this was an unpopular opinion, but actually a lot of people in the chat are saying that they agree. Kilroy 00011. Whoa! Don't play on the Wii, only play on the GameCube.
Am I supposed to, like, light the fire?
Wow!
Oh, I'm back in the computer.
Yeah.
So we've done the computer one before, and we've won the computer one.
Yeah.
That was weird. I wonder if I actually passed that one or not.
Right?
No, I mean, I think anytime you kind of, like, have motion controls kind of, like, shoved in there in some capacity.
Which one haven't we done?
We've done all of them, which is why I kind of shot off screen because I wanted to do this.
Oh, again, the arrow one. Yeah.
Which seems like...
We can get to a bunch of them from here.
Yeah, I don't want to do him again. Ooh, there's
What's that?
What is that? It's like a...
Oh, man.
Dark... Oh, great. Another... Oh,
he's
look at
like
those.
Such a deflatey balloon.
What is this? Ooh, ooh.
Oh, he's
no!
coming. He's coming for you.
No!
He's coming for you.
No!
Run away, run away!
Man, I love these 3D levels. The 3D levels are...
Run! Oh my gosh!
Yes!
Run away!
Go!
Gotta get out of there, man!
Oh, I gotta touch all of them, I think.
Oh.
Right? That seems to be the case. The sound cue has symbolized to me that this is something... Yes!
Oh, hey!
Okay, so now we're back here.
Now we're still a bit of fuzz.
Ooh, oh, I want to be a fly.
No, nope, don't be deflating balloon.
Ooh.
Right? We don't want to be deflating balloon?
No, I do want to... So, what I'm collecting is water as I go up.
Oh, look, you're getting to be a little storm cloud.
So I'm becoming a little
That's
bit
so
more
cute.
Of a cloud.
Oh,
shoot. So I'm back here.
Shoot.
Let's go back to
Arrowland. Okay.
There we go. We did the hand. There's the dark balloon. It's this guy. Ooh, what is that? Ooh, what?
Whoa. Oh, this is a new one. Oh, we're like soggy French fries.
Ooh, there are knives being hurled at me.
All right. Oh, we got a turtle. That was
Whoa.
Cool.
What is this?
Oh, man.
So I gotta, like,
tough.
Move. Ooh.
Oh, jeez.
Wow. This is intense.
You're so floaty and soggy.
It is. I am a soggy French fry. Okay, oh. I gotta just keep moving those over and over again? Nope.
Oh my gosh.
That's a huge heaping helping of nope.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
Is it reducing the size of that pile?
Is it? I can't tell.
I don't think it is.
No, it's just gotta get over. Okay.
Okay. Oh,
we just gotta keep going.
Oh, it's almost like a Rube Goldberg almost style thing.
Yeah.
Woo, 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 woo.
Oh. Oh my gosh.
Launch! Yes!
Oh, nice. Oh, it's like a boss battle.
Oh, it's a boss battle.
It totally is.
Okay.
Press this. Good. Then launch it. Oh, my gosh.
Okay. Watch out. Watch out for sword nose.
Yep.
Launch it.
Oh, we got him.
We
didn't get him.
We did not get him. So apparently you have to hit him in the face. Duly noted.
Yep.
I didn't know if, like, I could shoot him anywhere.
Yep.
Apparently that is
not
the case.
No, I think that he's, like, producing smoke underneath
him.
Go, hit him. I think we got hit by the knife.
I don't know if I was. Maybe I beat him.
What is this?
Maybe we broke the game.
I don't think this game can be broken.
Yeah, the unbreakable game. So did this? The game? Can you break what is already broken?
I think we got hit by a sword.
Yeah, I think maybe you were on the catapult.
I think that is actually what happened. Uh-huh. Honestly. Yes, hit him.
No.
Ah. I'm excited to collect 500 of these collectibles and see
what
happens when I hang out with
them.
Go, launch it.
Face.
Hit him.
No.
Oh, hit him. Oh. Oh, I think we might have gotten him.
Oh.
Come on, be like a Nintendo boss and let me hit you three times.
Three times. That's it.
Go.
Right.
Go.
Go, launch. Go.
Yes. Yeah! Okay, that's two. Okay. That's two. That's clearly two. All right. Most epic boss battle in all of gaming, right here. Floaty controls versus sword spitter. Go. Soggy fry.
Go.
Yes!
Awesome.
Why did you do that? Now we are doomed. What was our protector?
Oh no. The little piles of weed won't be able to.
Wait, we just killed their protector.
Oh no! That's so sad. The little grass blobs.
But see, that's
just
the.
Just like Mario.
Yeah, it's just like any Zelda game. You kill, like, Goma. And it's like, oh, we just killed this ancient deity that has existed in this temple forever.
But it speaks to the fact that there's some point, right? Like, it speaks to the fact that there's some reason that there are good guys and bad guys and that you don't really know what side you're playing on?
Yeah, if this game was purely random, that wouldn't exist, right? Like, you wouldn't have moments like that where it's like, hey, why did you kill our god, basically? What is this?
Oh.
What is this? Ooh.
Oh, he's so cute!
Oh, it's
cute.
Collect the presents, but don't get hit by the
hammers.
Alright.
Oh, he's so cute!
That isn't too bad. I say.
Oh!
That isn't too bad!
Mm-hmm.
I say as I get crushed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, go back to that one.
Yeah, I want to be able to do this one. Okay.
Matthew S. says he's a pro soda drinker. Let's see. You guys should play the cave. Let's see.
Ooh. Come on, kid. Get out of there.
The Great Cookie, first live stream.
Hey!
And also...
Yes!
Yukine Kakashi?
Oh no, I got...
My first live stream.
Impressive.
Oh no, what happened? Did you collect all the presents?
What is going on?
Oh no!
Oh, I gotta fight. It's another boss battle.
Oh, yeah!
Ooh, hey. I'm fine. Oh no!
Oh.
Okay,
we gotta go back.
But we are... Okay, so we've learned stuff, though. So again... We're being put in these positions where we are having to fight, like, boss battles and stuff.
Yeah.
We got two.
Oh, nice.
So we got... Ah, yes. The building achievement. I don't even remember. What was that from? And we got... Oh, the dark one. Okay,
nice.
We got the dark steam one, so
okay,
that's
good.
Yeah, I want to
hop back to there. We got to meet that boss. Nice.
As I shoot my irons at him.
Is it iron?
It is literally iron.
Well, he does look a little wrinkly. That makes perfect sense.
Okay. Nope. Oh, come on. Shoot.
Man, it's a one-hit kill, too.
Everything in this game is a one-hit kill.
Which, no, but I was thinking about that earlier because that's actually harder than a lot of other games. Like, you can't take any hits in any part of the game.
Jump to the top. Oh, that's all we got. Okay.
Yeah.
What about all the ones that we've uncovered?
I know.
Here we go. Try again. Okay.
Ty gives you a pro tip, so keep calm and Diet Coke.
Right, the Diet Coke is helping.
I know.
Look at me! Run out of turtles. Yes, Diet Coke! Oh, I got his tail now.
Ooh, okay.
Okay, it's all about his tail.
You're tailing it.
Yes!
Yeah! Oh, wait, what?
You use the back cannon. Yes. Cool. Awesome.
What?
Great. So now I'm an actual human.
No way! We graduated to human being?
Oh, hey. Against
giant trees. And are hanging out with trees with shovel feet.
Oh, this guy's sad.
Oh, no. Oh, he wants the yo-yo.
We have a yo-yo.
We can give him a yo-yo.
We should have the yo-yo, so let's give him the yo-yo. Let's make him happy. Oh no, does he not have the yo-yo anymore? Do we not have the yo-yo anymore?
Where is our yo-yo?
Oh no! Wait.
Shoot.
Ah! Wait. Here we go.
No yo-yo?
Wait, oh darn it. That didn't help the problem of part of the screen being off. Darn it! Alright, well, that is what it is.
Shoot. I thought we had it though.
We do have the yo-yo. We should. Here, one sec. Put it into window mode as in like. What do you think, Jason?
Like,
if I hit.
Is there. When you push escape, is there a option?
Probably not. Oh no!
Oh wait, what? What happened?
Oh, no. Oh, garbage!
Oh, what? No!
Turn it. Number one. Okay, we're gonna use the back cannon on this guy. Nope!
Oh! Shoot.
So this just resets.
Yeah.
One.
Nice. That was quick.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Okay, good.
You used the back cannon. You are
correct.
Excellent.
It's weird. It's like slightly different.
It is slightly different. That's weird. Right. I'm so depressed that we...
can't access the yo-yo?
We had the yo-yo before.
Where did we get it?
It was in the, like, house, I think.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, now we are... Oh, no. This is...
We're like a...
We are a peanut-mobile.
Oh, you're right. I guess?
Okay.
It looks like a baby buggy kind of thing.
Okay, red. Nope. Red. Red, green. Oh. Great game.
Cool.
Great game. A plus game. Thank you, game.
All right, we're almost out of these things.
We're at the bottom of our.
Yeah. Shoot.
Okay, wait for it.
Okay.
Green. All right. Okay, go back. Back.
Weird.
Oh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That was a thing. Okay.
Okay, which way do I go, left or right?
Right.
Let's do right. Okay. Oh, there he is. Okay, there's the ending of this one. Green. Yeah. Ooh, don't want to go through the portal.
Go this way. Yeah.
Yay!
All right.
New person.
Have we
oh my gosh, we're in Plock!
Yeah.
It's like Plock. This is exactly what Plock looked like.
Oh, nice. There's your mouth, people.
That guy's gonna attack me. gotcha. There we go. Ooh, oh, look! That's one of the Sonic, like, screwdriver things that we need. That the guy asked us to get.
Sweet.
What's up here? What's up here?
Jeff!
Yeah. What's going on up here in this game? Ooh, that is a drop off.
What's going on?
Ouch! Come on.
Honestly.
Come on! Wait, let's see what we unlocked. I feel like we both unlocked a couple things.
All right.
One.
Just the one.
Got one! It's solid one.
We've gotten like 10 today, though. If you add them all up, maybe 6. But still. But it felt like 10.
The boot. We got the...
We got the boot. We gave him the boot.
That's the bat cannon.
Yeah.
No, I didn't get anything for my peanut racing?
Shoot.
What about my peanut racer? I was very fast in my peanut.
Right?
My peanut skills were on point.
You were a speedy legume.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Pride myself on my legume abilities. Let's buy a couple of these. Since we're running low on the turtles. And I also want, I want to save up so I can get the 500 point basket thing. Mm. Which I may or may not remember how to get back to. Again, it's like such an interconnected maze. This is almost like whatchamacallit from Super Smash Brothers. Subspace Emissary, where all, like, the final labyrinth, they're all kind of interconnected in some way.
There you go.
That was pretty easy. So, last time... Nope. Okay, what do we got up here? Ooh, look at that guy in the background just getting jiggy with it.
Yeah, he is. Na 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 na. Na 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 na.
Do you want to phase through the portal?
Nah, I don't, not yet. Go elsewhere.
I feel like there's more to achieve.
Yeah, we gotta figure something else out here.
Maybe not though. Maybe.
I don't know. Give it a good look-see around.
I mean, we did though. Last time we
really,
went
there's
far.
Nowhere else to go, like down or like down into the right or anything like that.
Let's see. Well, there's the giant mouth.
Right.
Yeah, you got that. You already got like the.
I don't think that. Yeah, we got that. Yeah. Ooh, no, but there is more. Okay, you're right, Steph. Well, there's one of those. There's a mega one.
That's not like.
That's not what we're really looking for, though.
I think this space was only more connected.
Yeah, the mega.
Yeah, there's like one thing to do in each space, I guess.
Okay, let's teleport right. back. Okay, so now we're back to the brain.
Okay.
Let's shoot one of the babies. There we go.
Aww.
Let's shoot. Oh, not this one. Oh,
shoot.
This one? No, I'm not. This one.
And we're
thanks,
done.
Thanks, Jason. I see. You were being sarcastic. Mm. You were being what is known as sarcastic. You're the best, buddy.
Alright, I'm gonna hop into the chat now. Hold
we're on. At 325. We're getting close.
Are we going for 500? What?
It's
what
gotta
are we
be
going for
not
here?
The levels.
It's gotta be 500 collectibles, right? Here, let's see what this guy has to say now that we got one. Find the other two. We gotta find the bird and like.
And like the blueberry.
Oh, no, the blue. Oh, that one. The blueberry is from underwater.
It is?
Yes. It's that one that we played last time when we did the underwater, like in the dark level.
Okay.
Which you, I know how to get to. I remember.
Okay.
That one though, we have to restart the whole thing in order to do that.
So you want to give one?
Yeah. Let's grab a wood.
Okay.
To light your fire.
Come on, baby, light my fire. There we go. Come on, baby, light my.
All right, in the meantime, I'm gonna hop into the chat. Nightcore Oasis says, hey, Steph, first live stream. I'm from Archive Land. Can I get a clap and a half?
You
yes.
Can.
Let's see. Where was this posted? On YouTube. Or the game? The game, where did the game actually, where did we actually get it? Steam, right?
I think it's Steam.
Isn't it on Steam?
It's on Steam.
Yeah, because there were like Steam reviews out
Steam.
About it and stuff.
No,
first live stream from Maddie Thomas. Let's see.
Oh, yeah.
Hosha from Cleveland. Woo woo.
I do remember.
Oh yeah.
Oh.
Alright.
Oh.
Shane says buy wood. Where is he going? Says Evie Thane. That's really
that's the question for
exactly
all.
Exactly what we're trying to figure out the whole time in this game. Oh jeez. They don't really give you the benefit of the doubt with that.
This one's just really the timing on this one is just really uncomfortable. You gotta start with the first one, though. Oh, no, no!
The Irrationalist says, let's shoot one of the babies.
Shoot.
And other things that prevent Matt's
no!
presidency.
No! Oh!
First stream caught live from Haiti, Co-Tiffany, coming from Archive Land. Let's see.
Get out of there, worm! Wood move for me.
Fairy Tale Forever says hi, Steph. Hi, Fairy Tale Forever.
A little bit more wood. I'm gonna try to evaporate again.
Okay. That's always a good idea. Just evaporate. Should I be watching this at school? Says Hans Plum.
I thought I had one more. I bought two woods. I bought two solid woods, game. Oh, garbage.
Apparently, you have to buy it every time you want to.
Well.
So we are.
I know. Now we're back.
Yeah.
I'm gonna try to get into the water at least and see.
Yeah, do you wanna do that and then wrap there probably?
Yeah. Cool. We didn't lose the achievements.
Yeah. Shoot, did we lose all of our.
What? We lost all of our collectibles.
Oh no.
But not our, yeah. No, I don't think we lost the spiral or whatever. Yeah, we didn't lose like story progression stuff, we just lost like,
man.
Oh,
that's
the like
worst.
The like little yeah, these things.
Yeah. There are a bunch of people coming out for first stream saying hi. The chat is going really fast. While you're shooting it up in there, let's see. Ooh, Namit 255 asked your favorite soda other than Diet Coke. Chloe Cat says you can do it. And Life Sebastis says, explanation, I just hopped into the stream recently and I have no idea what's going on. You and everyone else.
Literally everyone else.
Yep. It's Soda Drinker Pro. It's a game about drinking soda, obviously, where you go to alternate dimensions and play as like 15 different characters, including this sad space jellyfish, and you win mini games. And then you are also a water droplet and you have to evaporate yourself into fires. And maybe there's an overall story. We're hoping.
You know, it's worth noting that thing that just killed me
was the thing that you killed the protector for.
Yeah.
Right? Yep.
That's interesting.
Yep.
It's all about the circle going. Ooh, this is a good one.
Anna B says, I'm from Archive Land and I like tea. What? What was that? What was that?
That was hilarious. You had a split second.
You have a split second to jump as soon as that. That's a good one. Oh, wow. They have all sorts
Whoa.
Of games. Whoa, there's all sorts of games.
Oh man, oh man!
Wow, no! There are all sorts of new ones now. This is so interesting.
Okay.
They're so different. Maybe we've entered into a new tier of the game.
Maybe.
They're like, oh, you've progressed beyond.
Right? Well, look, all these are new. Really? I must have been in the chat.
Nailed it.
All right. Sad jellyfish baby.
Yeah, the sad parachute jellyfish. Yeah, these are the guys that
we
killed before.
Those are those little grass blobs.
So this is the guy that we've hopped into and we need 500 mm-hmm. for, so that's good to know. This guy seems violent, I guess.
Right? We've never...
It's hard to tell. Ooh! Ooh!
Ooh!
What's that?
Don't hit that guy, flying egg saucer.
Yeah, the
Don't
egg.
Hit him.
Hit him.
Yeah.
Oh! When did he, what? He slapped me like...
He gained like dash ability.
Right? What happened there?
What was that?
This game, man. Cryptic. Hey, we got something though.
Ooh. Oh, we got that token.
Yeah, we got a token.
What is that?
It's the token that we got from outer space, apparently. We're filling it up in no time.
Right?
This Look
is
at us.
Just blazing on
We're
through.
We're flying through this game. We clearly know everything that's going on. It all makes perfect sense. It's all about the circle of life, Steph.
Obviously.
It's about people who hate one another, who get their protecting
gods
killed.
I thought we were in like the brain and the heart and stuff.
That too.
Become the right entity. So these are different now.
Oh no, French fry!
We've been French fry!
You have to do them all in the same batch, I think. But we are collecting the little, like, quantum turns.
Okay.
We're good at collecting the quantum turns,
Steph. That's true. We're pro quantum turd collectors, as well as pro soda drinkers.
Soda drinkers, quantum collectors.
Darn it.
This is a weird game, guys. I don't know if you've noticed.
Right? All right.
Why are you telling me to stop? I know we have a phone
call.
So
we're not, we're not really close to like a boss or something like that.
A boss?
I don't even know what it would be. You know?
Oh no!
It's like a very strange version of a claw game. Okay.
Okay.
So yeah. And then we actually have a meeting at 6 o'clock. So we have to go get ready for that too.
Yeah. All right.
But the thing is, it's still really interesting. What I think we should do is what you mentioned early on, is actually play a little bit in the background, figure it out a little bit more, and then come back with our ideas and see what you guys think about them.
I agree. Yeah, let's hop into
this one. Oh, he's just like this Frankenstein head.
Hey, we beat the game.
Yay!
Yeah, that was it!
You're welcome!
That's it.
Right? We did it, guys! You're welcome, random character.
Ooh.
That's what
launched us. Can we hop into the live stream?
No, that's what launched us up last time. Oh. So it like kind of resets you in this level. Woo.
Ooh. Okay. All right. Watch out for that dash ability.
Watch out for the dash.
All right.
Soda drinker pro. I don't know if that's physically something that should be happening right now, but okay. Whee! It is hard to tell what you can and can't jump into in this game. Usually if it has sharp teeth, the answer is no.
He doesn't have sharp teeth, though. He just looks like a clump of grass.
He does look like a clump of grass. But
or like Cousin It.
He's also moving with purpose, though. Gotta watch out. You can't
possess
people. You
gotta look for the ones that are wandering aimlessly.
Can't possess people who are wandering with purpose. Mm. Alright, then we watch that.
Alright.
Ah! Well, here we go. That's that briefcase, though.
Alright.
For reasons.
So weird.
Right? I thought the briefcase was a collectible that you would have gotten.
You thought that about the yo-yo, though, as well.
Yeah, and then the yo-yo disappeared on us.
No.
Ooh.
Oh.
Woo!
Whee!
Oh. There you go. Launch me again. Launch me again.
Yay! Whee! Okay.
Launch me again. Woo!
Ah.
Okay, here we go.
No, that's the edge of the world over there, it looks like.
Come on, parachute man.
Go! You got this, little dude.
Wait, I want to go down here because there's stuff right here.
Is there? Oh, I think it's just like a random layer of, yeah. Whee! Alright, I think that's about it.
For today.
Yeah. Alrighty.
Let me at least get to it.
So, how are you gonna get out of here?
That's great question, Steph. You ask the best questions.
Right?
Truly.
Truly
your questions are second to none. You ask as though I have
what
an answer to
this game. What is going on in
this
game?
Again, you do ask
right?
The most stellar of
super
questions.
Super pertinent.
Oh!
Oh, go!
No!
No! No! Oh.
Okay.
Alright.
I think I'm just gonna possess that guy.
Right. Let's just do that.
Yeah! Oh, jump.
Oh my gosh.
Whoa, okay. Hey.
Hey, buddy.
You're welcome. No need to thank me. Been there,
just
done that.
Just doing my job.
Just doing whatever I
gotta
do for.
Little astral jellyfish.
This game. So bizarre.
I hope there's
a meaning to it all.
Oh
I hope
gosh.
That there is a meaning. Alright, so maybe. Okay. Right.
Ah.
So. There you
go. Come on. Go.
I like that we're like. I thought I would be able to escape this level faster. My bad. Ooh, no.
Nope, alright. Okay.
So we might just be stuck in this section right here. Yeah, right. Yeah. Thanks, Jason. You're the best.
Jason.
And over and...
He wants you to suicide that poor little jellyfish.
How dare he. Oh, there he is. No, this is what I... That's way too hot. You can't do it. All right. So anyway, hey guys, thank you so much for watching.
Soda Drinker Pro.
Today was a bit tougher.
Yeah.
It was a bit of a challenge. Hey, we're gonna go and play this in our own free time. We'll see what we determine.
Right?
Because clearly all the mysteries of this game are coming together. It makes perfect sense.
It's gonna be
now.
All in the mix. This is gonna make perfect sense next time.
Now, if you excuse me, I just have more emotional Diet Coke to drink.
All right.
Thank you so much for watching, and remember, that is just a stream, a live stream. Thank you for staying carbonated and bubbly.
Ooh, that sounds good.
Somewhere in the chat.
Thank you for staying effervescent.
Lost Diamond, I got to go. Bye. Well, bye. Totally, so there you go.
Well, geez. Malachi Hobbs says bye.
I have another Alexa ad. Nicole Huerta says, what's going on? Your guess is as good as ours.
Alex D says, see y'all in archive land.
David Day says, D.
Askin Light says, bye.
BD. Emera Bright Bite Game says, do you guys do this every day or every other day? We try to do it most days.
Yes.
Most weekdays.
Most weekdays at 4 p.m. Pacific time. Gadriel Phillips broke my leg, but still have time for GT Lab.
Clap and a half for you. Feel better.